The city of Minneapolis has been celebrating the Aquatennial for 84 years.
As the working class awake.
But that celebration could be part of a darker history, according to historian Peter Ratcliffe.
The unity that the Aquatennial was celebrating was a unity that tried to hide the kind of conflict that had gone on in Bloody Friday.
Ratcliffe and the Remember 1934 Committee are working to spread awareness about Bloody Friday, or the violent chapter of the trucker strike in 1934. By July 20th of that year, pressure had been mounting for weeks between the Teamsters and a board of business owners who often deployed the police to break up the strikes.
67 strikers were shot by the police, and two of them died.
Governor Floyd Olson declared martial law, and the union declared victory after a settlement was reached weeks later.
Tremendous impact on labor all across the country.
Although the possible connection between Bloody Friday and the Aquatennial isn't on the record, the president of the organization that puts on the annual fest, the Minneapolis Downtown Council, acknowledges the possibility.
Given the timelines that happened in 1935 and then the civic celebration was planned in 1940, it's possible there's a connection.
Despite the controversial origins of the celebration, Adam Dunnick believes there's room for celebrating both the labor victories and the city's unity in the Aquatennial.
To me, the unity around celebrating the city should involve all of us. You know, we want a downtown that reflects everybody. That means the people that work in the tall towers and everybody that works as to clean them. It all takes all of us, and I think a unifying civic celebration like Aquatennial, we should bring that message together, bring those communities together.
It isn't about a dead history looking backwards. It's about how do we use the history to go forward and learn the lessons?
Minneapolis artist Keith Christensen is working on behalf of the 1934 committee to ensure the memory of Bloody Friday makes it to the next generation. Christensen and the committee have set up a series of events, including this art gallery in the Minneapolis Central Library, to commemorate the 90th anniversary of the strike.
It helps people to go forward. It helps to know there's a legacy of caring about each other to make the world better.
And they made Minneapolis into a union town.